Welcome to ENTREE, 9 conversations about basic Christianity. This session is the third in our series on open minds. This session will concern United Methodism and the Wesleyan Quadrilateral. The Christian Protestant denomination of Methodism began as a lay evangelical movement within the Church of England. Early in the 18th century, brothers John and Charles Wesley began holding weekly Holiness Club meetings during their time as students in Oxford, England. Rather than being insulted when disparaged for an overly disciplined, methodical schedule of study and prayer, the brothers took pride in becoming known as Methodists. Small groups met regularly, holding members personally accountable in matters of spiritual growth. John Wesley worked to abolish slavery and to improve conditions in factories and prisons. Along with George Whitehead, he preached to workers outdoors. Hark the Herald Angels Sing is one of the most famous of the thousands of hymns written by Charles Wesley. From 1736 to 1739, the young Wesley brothers spent time, less than successfully, as missionaries in the American colonies. 30 years later, John Wesley sent 2 lay preachers to the colonies, where in 1784 the lay initiative, which originally sought only to reform the Anglican denomination, was formally recognized as the independent Methodist Episcopal Church. The spirit or winds of change, however, continued to blow through Christian denominations. Which reacted during times of political strife, war, and cultural change by merging, splitting, and merging again. At the turn of the 21st century, the worldwide United Methodist Church shrinking membership in Europe and America is countered by the growth of African and Asian congregations. Speaking from Lenexa, Kansas, the Reverend David Livingston advises that an American church with declining numbers should not be mistaken for a church in decline. The 2011 State of the Church report challenges an aging membership to renounce any uninspired and uninspiring focus on institutional maintenance and to look to younger generations for leadership in recovering a sense of urgency of the church as a movement once again. And just how might members of a denomination, which encourages a wide range of viewpoints, decide on a right course of action, whether individually or together? Through balanced and thoughtful consideration are the 4 precepts of what is known as the Wesleyan Quadrilateral: Scripture, Tradition, Reason, Experience. According to theologian A.C. Oatler, these 4 elements, taken together, bring the individual Christian to a mature and fulfilling understanding of the Christian faith and the required response of worship and service. As has been observed elsewhere, United Methodism is not a creedal church. As stated in the Evangelical United Brethren's 4th Article of Faith, whatever is not revealed in or established by the Holy Scriptures is not to be made an article of faith, nor is it to be taught as essential to salvation. Tradition is experience and the witness of development and growth of the faith through the past centuries and in many nations and cultures. Through reason, the individual Christian brings to bear on the Christian faith discerning and cogent thought. Experience is the individual's understanding and appropriating a faith in the light of his or her own life. To repeat Oatler's words, these 4 elements, taken together, bring the individual Christian to a mature and fulfilling understanding of the Christian faith and the required response of worship and service. The Methodist Church has long been known for a wide variety of missionary work, including the foundation of hospitals, universities, and orphanages. UMCOR, the nonprofit United Methodist Committee on Relief, works in more than 80 countries to alleviate suffering caused by war, conflict, and natural disaster. Unfortunately, war, conflict, and disasters of all kinds remain in plentiful supply. Thoughtful Christians continue to disagree on many issues, particularly within what has been called the stubbornly centrist and so far stubbornly united Methodist Church. Clergy and laity are united in their efforts to reinvigorate the United Methodist denomination as a worldwide movement, attempting to assure that all voices are heard around the recently established connectional table through inclusion of persons of all ages and cultures from around the globe. Huge challenges remain, however, in a church striving for consensus among so many varied traditions. Of the quadrilateral worldwide, Methodists hold scripture and reason in common, but extreme diversity exists in cultural traditions and experience. Social principles, which are revised every 4 years, are a prayerful and thoughtful effort on the part of the church to address such contemporary issues from a traditionally sound biblical and theological foundation. The principles are a call to faithfulness in the best prophetic spirit, but are not church law. We shall consider these principles during the ENTREE session entitled Going Out, Serve in the World. Recently added to the membership vows of this denomination are the words, "And your witness." This refers to the Great Commission, which is the stated purpose of the United Methodist Church. Quote, "The mission of the church is to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world," unquote. Referring back to the challenge issued to the baby boomers who now control the church, are we more interested in signing up new members to bolster the institutional status quo, or in catching the wave and wind of the Spirit for the transformation of the world and ourselves along with it? That Spirit's appearance as tongues of fire over the heads of the apostles at Pentecost inspired the United Methodist logo of cross and flame. Under the discipline of the Spirit, the Church exists for the maintenance of worship, the edification of believers, and the redemption of the world. We applaud those attending these ENTREE sessions because, far from ending with confirmation, a Christian's edification or education should never end. To meet the challenges before us, we must be as wise as serpents, innocent as doves, and never stop talking with one another. We hope that by now you feel comfortably at home within the doors of this United Methodist Church. How do you and your family make decisions? Does the Wesleyan Quadrilateral make sense for you?